Hello viewers, in this part of the program we shall discuss about the topic selection of the topic. Now the topic which I am going to discuss is selection of topic, the topic for research, the topic for which you want to write a paper. Developing and selecting a good subject for research is not an easy task, but it can be made easy by certain steps. It can be easier if the instructor or the guide or the supervisor which you have chosen provides you a broad outline of the topic or the subject. But if you have to do it on your own, there can be certain points which must be taken care of, which must be followed, and you can have a good topic for yourself. Let us talk one by one about them. You have to be open mind and find out what are the ideas coming into your mind. We can say that brainstorm your ideas, then choose a topic that will enable you to read and understand the literature, whatever is available as literature already available. You can understand that, that can also be a topic for further research. Ensure that the topic is manageable and the material is available, otherwise there can be your imagination, there can be certain thoughts you might be having as brainstorming, and you may not find enough material for that, enough information for that, then it may be difficult to write a paper on that particular subject. Then you should be able to define the research area in which you want to go. And at the same time, you have to be flexible also. Flexibility means you can add or subtract certain points, certain areas which can be allied subjects or allied areas which may be directly not related to your topic, but those subjects can be of interest, those problems can be of interest. They can be added or subtracted from your topic of research. So you need to be flexible, you cannot be rigid while selecting the topic. Then research you have to do on whatever is already available on the net, and then formulate a thesis statement. These are the steps which you have to follow. We will be going for them one by one, and in broad sense you can select the topic following these ideas. The brainstorming for ideas can be like what is your interest, your interest in the subject, and then there can be a sub subject or sub area of that particular choice in which you want to work. You may be related with politics, political science, you may be related with history, the ancient history, the contemporary history, Indian history, you may be interested in music, you may be interested in medical science, you may be interested in paramedical. What are your interests? Then find out any particular subject in those areas. There may be certain research paper or news article which you have read recently, and that has created some curiosity, and you can use that also. This is kind of brainstorming. Some ideas are coming into your mind and you are trying to have some kind of authenticity on those areas which may be available as already research topics, but you can enhance them, you can find out something new areas into that already research topic. Then you can be interested into humanities, arts related subjects. The science and arts combination can be there, the interdisciplinary subjects can be there. So you have to do brainstorming, rigorous brainstorming, and at the same time whatever is coming into your mind, note down those keywords, note down those areas, so that later on you can find out, you can relate them with each other to develop the research topic. Next point is to find out the background information, the general background information which you can collect from the encyclopedia, the newspapers, the magazines. Remember, we are not still in the process of writing the paper. We are just trying to select a topic. But whatever ideas, brainstorming you have done, and those ideas came into your mind, you have jotted them down on the paper, and then you are trying to find out more information, which can be general in sense, which may be through encyclopedia, certain definitions may be required, some newspapers maybe you can refer to, then certain websites which are providing you the details, maybe there are certain journals, certain books may be there, you can talk to your instructor or your guide or your supervisor about those topics, and then something can come up, so that you can develop interesting subject or interesting topic for research. Then after the discussion with the instructor, after your brainstorming, after finding out the general information, there is a requirement of developing the idea, the scratch, but keep in mind that it should be manageable. Manageable in the sense, it should not be very broad, it should not be very small or restricted, so that you may not find enough material when you are developing it for the paper or the research paper. And if it is broad, then you may not be able to write a small paper on that. Maybe you need to write a book, and then more efforts would be required, and that may not be the need of the hour when you are writing a paper. You are writing a paper for some journal, you are writing the paper when you are doing your PhD research, or for that matter to attend certain conference which is on one particular topic, and there are certain sub areas are there on which you want to work. So you have to keep your subject or the topic if it is manageable or not. Manageable means, what is the meaning of manageable? You can think about certain areas, say for example, if you want to find out the what is the geriatric health conditions, then instead of going to the world or trying to find out the geriatric situation of the people, you can have it for the person or people living in Rajasthan or living in Maharashtra or living in Kerala, or maybe a sub part of it, maybe a district of it, so that it is manageable for you to get the data and to research upon that. Then you can have the restriction based on the time frame, so that you can manage. Trying to write a paper in which some time frame is required, instead of talking about the environmental situation in India, we can say that environmental situation in the last 10 years or last 5 years. So you need to talk about last 5 years only. That means it is manageable. Or you can say that it is for last 2 years if the requirement is like that. So according to the time, according to the geographical area you are defining, so that it is limited. Then there can be constraint you can put in is according to the discipline. Discipline means the people who are working, the people who are doing business, the people who are farmers, and if you are talking about the health of businessmen or health of working women or health of daily wage workers. So you are limiting this kind of research, so that can also be manageable. If you are talking about the health conditions of people of India, that is very, very vast, very broad topic, which is not manageable into a limited time frame, which will be there all the time when you are writing the paper. At the same time, you have to think about that if it is, the topic is too localized. Too localized means there may not be enough literature available on a small village or a small town where you want to get the research done. So this is a kind of combination, a kind of arrangement you have to find out for yourself if the topic is too localized. At the same time, one more thing I would like to add here, if the topic is too recent, too recent means the information which you are getting is only in the newspapers. There are not enough literature available, there is no proper research is there. So, it would be very difficult for you to write something on that. We are talking in general terms. The topic is recent. For example, if you can think about a particular phenomena which is happening in that particular local village or town, and the news has just come in the newspaper, earlier nobody was aware about that, how you can justify it? You need to do more research on that. So, you have to take care about it. And at the same time, if the topic is too popular, if the topic is too popular means most of the people are knowing about it, much of the research has already been done. So, what you are going to do? Because most of it is going to be there already on the research papers or in the literature. So, it should not be too recent, it should not be too popular. You have to take care in both the end points of the subject. Then, when you are doing all this, you need to keep the track of the keywords which you are using or finding out or coming across while you are searching for the topic. You should keep the track of the words that are used. You should be able to find out the meaning, the proper meaning of all those words. You should find out the proper words which are best describing your topic. And you have to find out the synonyms also. You have to find out the key concepts also. You have to note down the key words also, so that your topic can be prepared, can be written in a very beautiful manner, so that it can create certain interest of the reader. Then I mentioned somewhere earlier that you should be flexible. What is the meaning of flexible? That once you have defined the topic, once you have written the topic, you have selected the subject, you have finalized, almost finalized, and at a later stage you find something which is not available or you find some more which is can be added, then you should be flexible to do those modifications into your research topic. You may find too much and need to narrow your focus, or too little and need to broaden your focus. This is a normal part of the research process. So, when researching, you may not wish to change your topic, but you may decide that some other aspects of the topic is more interesting or manageable. So, you have to keep in mind the length of the paper, the length of the essay you are going to prepare, and accordingly you should be taking care of addition or alteration or deletion of the topic areas or subject or subtopics of the research subject. Here is a table which can be used as the standard. If the length is 1 to 2 page paper, then you can find out 2 or 3 magazine articles or websites to just define or write the paper, if you have to write 1 or 2 page paper. If it is 3 to 5 page paper, then you can have 4 to 8 items in which books can be there, articles can be there, popular articles can be there, news articles can be there, and websites. Of course, these days websites are very popular and easy way to find out the information which you want to put in. So, what I mean to say is, depending upon the length of the paper, you can define, you can search, and you can put in your efforts. You have to write only 2 pages and you are searching for 15 days or 20 days, then so much jargon of information will be there that you will not be able to write a single page. So, keep your mind limited to the topic. Keep it clean in your mind, clear in your mind that you have to write on those lines and search for only those things. There is so much of information available on net, so much of information is available in books. Books are written from different viewpoint, newspapers are coming from different viewpoint, and you have to find out what is actually needed for you. So, how much do you need? First decide that and then try to write accordingly. And the next step is define your topic as a focused research question. We often will begin with a word and develop a more focused interest in an aspect of something related to that word. Then we will begin to have the questions about that particular word when it is becoming a topic. For example, there is a difference between old architecture or architecture of old times and modern architecture. So, the question comes in my mind that why can't I compare these two, but this is very broad topic. So, what I think is that let us take one architect of old times, any famous one, I am not mentioning a name here, let us call it XYZ. And then can I have a comparison between XYZ architecture and the modern architecture, or the architecture which was developed by XYZ and the modern architecture? Yes, I can do. So, what can be the research question? The research question can be, how has XYZ influenced modern architecture? It is something which is very vague still, because how he has, that means there can be many aspects of that. Then what can be the focused research question? Focused research question can be that what design principles used by XYZ are common in contemporary architecture. And contemporary architecture can again be a broad size, that means architecture of buildings or large buildings or malls or homes, or so I can put any of them according to my choice, that what design principles used by XYZ are common in contemporary big buildings, contemporary homes, contemporary hospitals. I can compare these two things and can have a research. So, this can be a research question, focused research question on which I am going to develop my paper. The next point to be considered is read more and more and more about your research topic. The more you will read, the more you will find, more you will be able to clarify your confusions, and then you will be able to create a focused research topic, focused selection can be there. The keywords which you have gathered for the research, read them. Article database which you have created, which you have found out for yourself, the journals, the books, read them again and again, so that there can be an insight developed for yourself to find out what you actually want to do. You can do the research and reading before you are finalizing the topic. If you are able to find out enough information, you will be able to define the topic. Of course, there are many constraints based on the time available, the material available, you will be defining the topic. But if they are there, then if the information is not enough, you will not be able to. So, whatever information you are gathering, you have to go on and on with that, and then you can find out or finalize your topic. The next step is formulate a thesis statement. Thesis statement is the most important statement concept of the paper you are writing. We will be talking in details in the coming programs about what is thesis statement and how it is developed and written. But to come to the thesis statement, all these steps, starting from the brainstorming to find out the material, collecting the material, narrowing down your research area, focusing on research particular topics, and then find out what you actually want to do are important. The thesis statement is when you are writing actually into the form of a written matter, written form, it is required. In this part of the program, we have talked about the different steps or ways by which we can select a topic, starting from the brainstorming to find out the information in the newspaper, in the literature, in on net, and then trying to find out a research question, trying to narrow down your research topic are discussed in this particular program. Hope you have enjoyed. Thank you.